heartfelt apology to the family. That's my personal belief. And I think the whole thing should be dropped. I don't think that we should continue on with this. I don't know why the press is such in a frenzy over it. Just let it go.
Well, do you let think that I understand, but I mean, do you think it would have gone away if on the first or second day she had apologized publicly?
I don't know. I mean, I honestly probably, but I don't know. And the other thing I would say, Allison and Anna, is honestly, I mean, if somebody doesn't want to apologize, why would you want to force them to apologize? Don't tell me you're sorry if you truly don't mean it.
If it's not genuine. Yeah, I hear you. I think that that's a good point. So, Anna, what...
I think that's a perfect point to it.
Yeah, look, but what does make this go away? I mean, we are stuck in this loop because it doesn't feel satisfying. We don't know what the internal, what action has been taken. Is this okay? Is this tone okay in the White House? So what does make this go away, Anna?
Look, I don't know that it goes away because it seems that it goes away momentarily and then it comes back. Part of the reason that they really can't apologize is because Donald Trump has done much of the same. Donald Trump has been attacking John McCain with cancer or without cancer. He was a POW. He served this country since the age of 17. He is a national hero who Donald Trump has been attacking and calling a loser and saying he doesn't like him and he was only a hero because he was captured from day one, practically, of his campaign. He continued attacking and mocking him and leading chants against him at CPAC, at rallies in Arizona, even after the cancer diagnosis. So why can't they apologize? Because then Donald Trump would have to apologize. Donald Trump has called John McCain's family as well and promised he would never do it again and apologized and then has gone out and done it again. So of course it is a tone. Of course they can't apologize. It comes from the top. It stinks from the top.
And can I want to add something to this. Yesterday when the news broke about Melania, 2 minutes before, I had a breaking news alert about Harry Reid on my phone. 2 minutes later, the news alert came about Melania being in the hospital. As of this morning, right before we went on air, John McCain had tweeted to Harry Reid to get better. Not one tweet to Melania. So the bad blood goes both ways. Don't pretend that this is only going one way because it's not.
Do you think, Amy, that the tone comes from the top and that the president sets the tone in the White House?
I do think the president sets the tone in the White House. Yes, I do.
And so when there's a nasty tone, do you think it's the president's responsibility to try to fix that?
I don't think that the president didn't say this. If it was said, it was said by Kelly Sadler, and she apologized. And I think that that is sufficient for her to apologize, call and give a private apology to the family. It was not a public statement. It should have never been leaked. And if she was, in fact, doing her job, talking about vote counting, she made a matter-of-fact statement. I mean, that's all there is to it. I don't think she was joking about it. I don't know how you could make it into a joke. Mm-hmm. And I think it's shameful that anybody would go and leak something like this, but it just shows that people are out for themselves and not about what's best for the country.
I'm curious about that. What do you think it shows that this White House leaks so much, Amy?
I mean, I think it shows that people are out for themselves. I think that, you know, that they get attention. They leak for numerous reasons. I don't think it's helpful. And I think it's shameful. And whoever's doing it, if they were caught, I think they should be fired. I don't think it's helpful to our country. Uh-huh. When there's so much other stuff going on in the world right now and so many things that we should be focused on, and to be focused on something like this, it's absolutely ridiculous. And I think that the country and the people in this country deserve better.
And a last word. We only have 15 seconds.
Look, people leak because they want to make a point about having been in the room. It's an ego boost. But also in this case, because there's no loyalty. Most politicians have a team of loyalists that have been with them for years, if not decades. Donald Trump doesn't. He's got a bunch of people who are clawing all over themselves to see who's on top and who gets on top. We have seen this kind of drama. We have seen backstabbing in this White House from day one. And Donald Trump's tweet yesterday is laughable. The first part of the tweet, he says, oh, these are minor things. It's not really a leak. It's all made up by the press. But damn it, if we catch those leakers, those cowards and those traitors, we're going to get them. So which is it? Are there leaks or are there traitors and leakers? It makes no sense.
I think there's both.
And again, it's only Tuesday.
All right. On that note, Anna Navarro, Amy Kramer, thank you both.